Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. Today I'm going to show you how you can create pivot tables in Microsoft Excel to do some pretty amazing analysis. And as full disclosure, before we jump into this, I work at Microsoft. All right, well, what are we waiting for? Let's jump into it. Here I am on my desktop. I'm going to open up Microsoft Excel. The version that I'm using, this is the latest version of Excel, but if you have Excel 2019, 2016, 2013, you name the version, you should be able to follow along with this tutorial. So what I wanted to do is I wanted to come up with a fun example. And so today I'm going to pretend that I'm a used car dealer. So I have a spreadsheet called Car Inventory. I'm going to go ahead and open that. And one thing I want to do is first kind of help orient you to the data that I have in this spreadsheet. So what I have here is this is my inventory of cars that I have. As you can see, I have 24 vehicles in my lot. And it's a mix of different makes. I have Hondas, I have Toyotas, Nissans, Chevrolets, all sorts of, and then I have many different models, Accords, Camrys, Altimas, a variety of colors of vehicles. I think black and silver tend to be the most popular cars. So hopefully I have a bunch of those in my inventory. Then I have the different mileage amounts. Some of the cars have a little bit higher mileage, some of them have a little bit lower mileage. So kind of a nice little mix here. And then I have various price points. Now for the price, this is what I believe I can charge for the vehicle. So I've listed that. I've been working in this car business for a while, so I have a pretty good sense for what these cars will sell for. And then lastly, this is what I paid for the vehicle. And so you can see what my margin is here. I got $1,000 on the car if I could get the $4,000 because I only paid $3,000 for it. Hey, everyone's got to make a living, so I need to get a little bit of a margin there. So this is my data here, and now what I want to do is I want to do a whole bunch of analysis. I want to figure out, hey, what is my total profit margin across all of these cars? How many red cars do I have, or how many Hondas do I have? I have all these different questions about my data, and I want to analyze it. Now, what I could do is I could write a whole bunch of formulas. Like if I want to, you know, figure out what my margin on this vehicle is, I can enter a quick formula. But that takes a lot of time. Pivot tables simplify analysis and really make analysis a lot faster. In my job at Microsoft, I use pivot tables all the time, and it helps me to analyze data much quicker. And so today I want to show you how I do that. So what we're going to do is I have the data here. We're going to go up to the top bar and click on Insert, and you'll notice this option called Pivot Table. I'm going to click on that, but before I do that, I want to show one other option. There's also an option called Recommended Pivot Tables. So if I click on Recommended Pivot Tables, this is Excel recommending different pivot tables based on my data. So here they have a bunch of things. Like I could see the sum of the mileage by the different makes. And here I could go through and I could see some samples that they've set up. So kind of a neat thing that could help you really simplify pivot table creation. But today I want to show you how you could create your own pivot table from scratch. And so what I'll do now is let's click on this pivot table button. What it's doing is by default, it selects this table of data that I have. It's already pre-selected it. I could also change the selection if I want to, but Excel's done a good job of picking it. And then I could choose, do I want a new worksheet or do I want to put it on an existing worksheet? I'm just going to create a new worksheet with this data. So I don't want to change anything here. All this looks good. Typically when I get this, I just click on OK right away. All right, well, here I am. This is the main pivot table view. It looks a little intimidating at first. You have a bunch of different controls on the right-hand side. You have this other thing that says to build a report. So let's walk through how to do it. So you have a few different options here. You have filters. This is if you want to filter your data by any one of these fields. You have your rows, which is rows going down a sheet. And then you have your columns, which are going across the sheet. And then you have the values associated with that. Well, why don't we do a real example and then you can see how these work. I want to know how many cars do I have by make and model, and then by color, just to get a sense of what my inventory is. So the first thing I could do is I could click on these different items, and then I could drag it into these different boxes down below. So I'm going to take make, and I'm going to drop it in the rows column. So here, now I get a quick view of all the makes that I have on my lot. So I have Chevrolet, Dodge, Ford, Honda, Nissan, and Toyota. Now what I could do is I could also click on the model, and I could drop it down there, and now I could see the make and each of the models under that make. And what's kind of nice is I could expand and collapse these different sections. I could also collapse all the fields, or I could expand all of the fields using these buttons up here. I'm going to drag the color over to the columns. And so now here you see I have a table of the makes, the models, and the colors. And now I want to get a count. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take makes, and I'm going to pull that into values. And so now what this has done is it's set it to count. And now I can see a count by vehicle. So here, once again, I'm going to collapse it. So here you can see for Chevrolet, I have one green, one silver, and two white vehicles for a total of four vehicles. And what I'll do is I'll go ahead and expand this again. And now I could see that, you know, by the different models, what colors I have. So kind of a very quick way to visualize my data without having to go through the spreadsheet and filter or enter different formulas to get this data. With the pivot table, I could just do that automatically. Okay, let's say that I want to know what my profit margin is on my different vehicles. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the model out, I'm going to move the make out, I'm going to move the color out, and I want to know my margin by make. And so what profit margin is, it's the price minus the cost. So I'm going to pull the price in. Here you see this is basically what I expect to get if I were to sell all of these models. So once again, I'm going to pull the let's pull the make in again. So here you can see that I have my four Chevrolets, and I believe that I could collect $14,500. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to pull in the cost. And so here you can see, you know, I expect to be able to pull in about $14,500, and to buy all these vehicles, I had to pay $13,000. So what I could do now is if I want to figure out the margin, I'm going to click on this thing that says fields, items, and sets, and I'll insert a calculated field. All a calculated field is, it's basically doing a formula on different columns in the pivot table. So I'm going to click on calculated field, and then I'm going to call this my profit margin. And for the formula, what I want to do is I want to do the price. So I'm going to insert the price, and then we're going to subtract the cost. And I'm going to insert the cost, and I'm going to add this. What you'll see is it just added this as a field to my pivot table. So I'm going to click on OK, and now it's automatically added this to my table. So now you can see that I have four Chevrolets. I believe I could collect this. This is my cost, and then here's my margin. What's nice too is I could see, well, what make has the biggest margin? What, you know, I could look through this and figure out which one's the largest, or I could right click here, go to sort, and I could go from largest to smallest. So here I could see of my five Honda vehicles, I expect to make about $3,468. So that's my biggest margin that I have. So once again, pivot tables make analysis super easy. Now let's say that I wanted to know the average cost of my vehicles. So let me, I'm gonna pull some of these values out. I'm gonna get rid of the make. I'm going to get rid of the profit margin. So let's say for these different cars like Chevrolet, Dodge, what was the average price that I paid when I bought these vehicles? So here you'll see that this is currently set to the sum of the cost. What I could do is if I click on value field settings, I have all these different options. So instead of just looking at the sum of all that I paid for these vehicles, what I could do instead is I could say the average. So I'm going to click on OK. And now this changes it to the average. Now one thing I'm going to do just to make it easier to read is let's add dollar signs in. So here what this is saying is for my Chevrolets, I paid an average of $3,250 for each vehicle. And for my Hondas, I paid $2,500, and you can see on average how much I paid per vehicle. So once again, what I do there is I go to value field settings, and I could change it, you know, sum, count, many different options in this list here. Now the next thing that I want to do is I have my 24 cars in my inventory. I want to know what percentage I have of each color. So I want to know what percentage of my cars are red versus black versus silver. So what I'm going to do is let's go back, and I'm going to drop color in the row field. So we're going to drop that in, and then I'm going to pull in color here, and then I'm going to get rid of the dollar sign. So what you can see is I have six black cars, I have six silver cars. I'm going to sort this from largest to smallest again. So here you can see I have six silver, six black, and then three white, three blue, three red, and three green. But let's say I want to know the percent of silver cars that I have. What I could do here is I'll right click on this and I'll do show values as, and I have all these different options in this list. What I want to know is I want to know this silver, so in this column, this six, what percentage is that of the total? So once again, I'm going to go back to show values as, and I'm going to say percent of column total. And so now what I could see is my silver cars make up 25% of my inventory, my black cars make up 25% of my inventory, and so on and so forth. So there, you know, I could show the values as percentages. They have lots of different options that you could do, so you could play around with that. So what I want to do now is when you look at your data, seeing it in a table format, that's one way to read the data. But sometimes it's nicer to be able to see a graphical visualization of it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to click on Analyze again. And then there's an option that is Pivot Chart. I'm going to go ahead and insert a pivot chart. I'm going to go with columns. I could choose many different chart types, but I'm going to go with columns. And here what you can see is, this is a column chart of my car inventory. So here I could see, you know, 6 silver, 6 black, and then I could see the rest of it. So just a visual way of my table. And the really interesting thing is, you know, here what I could do is I could drop in different values into my pivot table, and then I could see, you know, the chart will just automatically update based on what fields I drop into my pivot table. So it's a very nice and easy way to pull together kind of a visual view of your data as well with pivot tables. One other thing that I want to call out is you have this option that says defer layout update on the bottom. What does that mean? Well, with defer layout update, as I pull items in and out, you'll see that it doesn't update my table and it doesn't update the chart until I click on update. So here, if I pull the color out and then click update, now it'll update only after I click that button. Why would you ever use that? Well, especially when you're working with very large data sets. So let's say you're working with 1 million or 2 million rows of data. Every time you drag and drop something into a pivot table, it's going to take your computer time to process because it's doing a lot of calculations based on how you set up your pivot table. And so this way, you can make sure that you have your setup good before you make that update. So it just helps speed up the process of editing. Now, I've created this pivot table, and what I also want to show now is not only is this available in Excel that I have on my desktop, but also in Excel Online. And one of the cool things is Excel Online is actually free to use. Here I am in my Excel Online, or I'm in my office.com. So I've gone to office.com, I've logged in. By the way, it's free to log in. If you're a paid user or a free user, you have access to this. And so here I see my recent document list, and my most recent spreadsheet is car inventory. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And now what it's doing is it's opening it in Excel Online. And what's nice is I have this file stored in OneDrive, so I edit it on my desktop, it automatically saves to OneDrive, and now all my changes that I just made are available in Excel Online. So I'm gonna click on sheet one because that's where the pivot table is, but here you can see my car inventory, I have that exact same data available here online. I'm gonna click into sheet one, and then here you'll see I have my pivot table, and I have the chart that I inserted on desktop Outlook. And you know, here in the online version, what I could do is I could go to insert, I could just as easily insert a pivot table. And then here, I could just as easily manipulate my data just like I could in Excel on the desktop. So whether you wanna use it on the web, whether you wanna use it on the desktop, pivot tables are very accessible and you could use them in either place. That was a quick overview of pivot tables. They're not nearly as intimidating as you think they are. And really the best way to start playing around with a pivot table is just to start dragging and dropping things into columns, into rows, into values, and just to play around with it. It's a very powerful way to visualize your data and to understand your data. In fact, in Excel, I very infrequently now enter formulas. I very infrequently enter functions because with pivot tables, I could already do most of my analysis there. So there's less of a need to do all these other formulas. And in terms of analyzing complex data or even simple data, pivot tables do a great job at doing that. And my job at Microsoft, it's helped me tremendously in terms of analyzing data and understanding data and making business decisions based on your data. Anyway, I hope this tutorial is helpful of using pivot tables. Hopefully this helps you creating your own pivot tables. If you enjoyed this content, please give it a thumbs up. That always helps reaffirm that the content that I'm creating is valuable. And if you want to see future content like this, please hit that subscribe button, and that way you'll get a notification anytime new content like this comes out. That's all I have. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Bye.